Guys, what's crack-a-lackin'? Retro Toy Closet back at you with a, let's say this is a Black Friday hunt slash bringing back old childhood memories slash mini unboxing. Okay, so for the first part of this, I'm going to show you what I found today. I didn't want to go Black Friday and I wanted to wait until the madness died down a bit. So here's the first item that I found for Black Friday. Okay, the brand new Jim Lee style Uncanny X-Men retro cards that they came out with for Rogue. I found her today at Target. $19.99 is the price point. Did not pay any of the scalper nonsense that's going on right now on the internet. So if you guys are interested in these figures, I'm going to give you a tip. Go on Google. Put in Retro X-Men Marvel Legends Rogue. It will bring up Target's website. When you get to Target's website, if you don't already have it set up, it's going to pull up the closest store to you and it's going to tell you if they're in stock or not. 9 times out of 10, a lot of these stores are stocking them and keeping them in the back. So you're going to have to ask somebody if you want these figures. But these are the brand new just came out retro card X-Men. They have Rogue and they have Gambit. I'm perfectly fine with the Gambit that came out, I believe, last year, so I didn't get him. I only wanted Rogue because she was one of my favorites growing up. But I think I'm just going to leave both of these in the card, and then maybe a rainy day I might open up one, because for the time being, I got this one right here. This is the Marvel Select version that came out a couple years ago. I believe it was last year is when I picked mine up. But if you look at them, they're pretty much the same figure. Like, they both have the gloved hand with the open fingers. See? It's pretty much the same figure. I know the Marvel Select is a touch taller, but I have my Rogue on the flight stand, so it's not going to be that noticeable, and I'm perfectly fine with that. So, I got two Rogues to add to the collection, and then this old girl gets to stay in place, so don't worry, Mama, you're going nowhere. Alright, next on my Black Friday mini hunt after work, shall we say, is this item. Okay, next on the list, we have the Heavy Infantry Mandalorian figure. Yes, this one came out last year on the original Black Series card. Then, you know, with the recent retro cards popping up left and right between Hasbro's Marvel Legends and then Hasbro's Star Wars, they came out with the Kenner style cards for the, I believe it was the 40th anniversary wave that they started doing it. Well, they brought it back again. And now we have the big boy, the Heavy Infantry Mandalorian. I believe the guy that was in the suit in the show was Jon Favreau, who was the director and creator of the show The Mandalorian. So eventually I felt like, yeah, I need this piece to go ahead and add to my Mandalorian shelf, because I do actually like the Mandalorian more than Boba Fett, more than Jango Fett. Hands down, I honestly think this storyline is like one of the better Mandalorians. A lot of people are going to hate me for that, but that's my own personal opinion, which everybody's entitled to their personal opinion. I like this version of the Mandalorian that they're putting out now. I like how they're keeping a story and flow with the original story, and it just feels like it all fits very well. So this one I got at Best Buy, and once again I did the same exact thing. Go on Google, put in Mandalorian, I think I put Best Buy, and then it pulled up my closest store and said this one was in stock. I walked right into Best Buy on the shelf. got myself a heavy infantry Mandalorian. Okay, so I wasn't going too crazy with Black Friday. There wasn't really too much that I wanted to get. And those two were the only ones that I went out to hunt. Because honestly, this time of the year, I try to avoid the stores as much as possible because it's a madhouse out there. Anyhow, I got this package right here. So this is going to be like a childhood unboxing, shall we say. My sister, she had hit me up out of the blue, says she has some of my childhood items that I didn't even remember that I gave her before I went to college, and she says she wanted to return them to me. So, I cut the bag ahead of time. This is me basically seeing this for the first time in almost 23 years, maybe 24 years. I can't remember when I gave them to her. I don't remember if I was 16, 17, or possibly right before I went to college at 18. So anyhow, let's see what my sister packed for us. Oh, yes. This is my original Roadmaster Transformer. That's a cool one right there. I loved this one as a kid. And it still has my original battle damage, shall we say, from when I played with it. And I play with my toys a lot. So I got that one right there. What else is in the bag? Oh. Oh, this is a throwback right here. My original Super Mario Brothers Nintendo watch. Look at that, guys. My sister hooked it up. I honestly forgot about these. But she kept all of them. And she returned them back to me. I gotta definitely open this up to see if the batteries are still good on this one. That's really cool right there. I'm sure JXP2 or Jason Black, both of my sons on Instagram. I guarantee one of them are gonna try to take this one from me. Alright, what else we got in here? Oh. Oh. Burger Power, what could this be? My original handheld Burger Time LCD game from 1982. Actually, I think I'm going to keep this one. This is like a definite like memento throwback of my childhood. I love this game. I played it a lot. You know, it was our basic technology that we had for back in the 80s. And this is a cool piece. So that's three items that I got right there from my sister, from my childhood. So I think I want to keep all of them. It's really cool, guys. Always hold on to your old stuff because you never know. You may get sentimental and want to have it back. Okay. I know over a week ago, it was before the Comic-Con, I told you guys I was going to do an unboxing for these two figures. Okay? I think I'm going to hold off on Venom because he's not officially in the MCU yet. And I'm quite happy with my original Toy Biz Venom that I have. I think he looks 10 times better on the shelf. And he has like a much more of a vicious presence, in my opinion. So, he's going to stay in the collection. So, I still haven't decided on Armored Batman because I really have nowhere to put him. Because his scale size is so huge. I had bought an extra one. He's up for sale on our Mercari page. So, if you're interested in it, check it out. Mention this video and I'll give you $5 off the price right now. So, this is the second one. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with this. My Batman figures, I have the Arkham. Here, we're about to go free fall, guys. I have the Arkham wave, and he's too big for that wave. So I really don't want to put him down there. And then I have a Mezco Batman, the Dark Knight Returns over here. And he doesn't fit on that scale size either. As I have the original Nightfall Batman right there. So, this guy right here, honestly, I'm just going to leave him right there for now. Probably hang him on the wall with everybody else. He's not going to go in the box, in the closet, and get hidden away or forgotten. It's a cool figure, but I just don't have anywhere that he's going to fit in. He's just going to look odd and out of place. Like, I could honestly put him with my Spawn that I have up here. Oh, yeah. That's my Gremlins. Got them all out. I could put him up here with Spawn, but I don't know. So, I'm definitely going to have to figure that out as to what I'm going to do with Azrael Batman armor. I don't know what I'm going to do with him. I like him. He's cool. Definitely a throwback fig to the Nightfall storyline, even though this is a newer version of the Azrael Batman. I don't know. I might actually look into reading that comic because I thought it was a badass story. Anyhow, this week, we have quite a few six scales coming in the mail. I had an unexpected surprise on one of them, so it should be here tomorrow. I have a huge Christmas box coming in from Big Bad Toy Store. I finally went ahead and shipped that out, so we'll go ahead and do an unboxing on that. And that's going to conclude this video, guys. So, as usual, stay retro, stay posted, and get ready for the next video.